Today, I want to discuss determining your plant's light requirements and supplying it uniformly over a given area. Back in the day when indoor growers flowered under HPS lights and batwing reflectors, folks used to talk in terms of watts per square foot. 50 was a number you heard banded around quite a lot. As a general guide for maintaining high light levels for flowering and fruiting with modern HID lighting, you should take the total square footage of your garden and multiply it by between 35 and 50, obviously lower numbers for more efficient lighting fixtures. Example, a 12 foot by 10 foot area, 120 square feet, will require between 4,200 and 6,000 watts. How you divide that into separate lighting fixtures, 400 watt, 600 watt, 750 watt, 1000 watt, etc., often comes down to the vertical space you have available for plant growth, the type of reflectors you wish to use, and the actual dimensions of your grow space. But your first step, get to know your plants. They're the finest par meters known to man, after all. What light intensity do they actually require? In this example, we'll shoot for moderately high, say 22.5 moles of light per day. To make things interesting, let's say we need to deliver all this light in a short 12-hour photo period. The math is straightforward. 1 mole equals a million micromoles, so 22.5 moles of light per day equals 22,500,000. The next step is to divide this huge number by the number of hours the lights will be on, in this case 12, and then divide the result by 60 squared or 3600. This series of divisions takes us from moles per day to micromoles per second. Et voila! Our target light intensity is 521 micromoles, ladies and gentlemen. This number is often referred to as the target PPFD, or photosynthetic photon flux density. Basically, it's a measure of plant usable light intensity that's actually hitting your plant's leaves. Let's imagine that we want to achieve this intensity over a 69 square foot area, or 6.6 square meters. This just so happens to be the measurement of my basement, or rather the part of it I want to actively grow in. It's high summer and all this PPFD testing would be horribly hot and a sweaty task if it weren't for my newly installed Con Adam climate controller, a compact, grower-friendly, reversible air conditioner. Thankfully, all testing will take place at a very pleasant and consistent 72 degrees Fahrenheit or around 22 degrees Celsius. Ah, you're gonna see my basement grow room upgrades very soon, including a range of high-powered LED fixtures. Oh yeah, but for now, back to our test. Note that the ceiling is just under 8 feet or 240 centimeters, and as regulars to my channel will know, I've tried 1,000-watt double-ended fixtures in here, and even when using air-cooled hoods, vertical growing space quickly becomes an issue. That's a shame because double-ended HPS is so efficient at creating plant-usable light. However, I might have found salvation in the form of these Adjustawings Hellion Double Ended fixtures. They can run a double-ended HPS lamp at 450, 600, or 750 watts, and they're brand new to the market, and I'm very excited to check them out. Four 600-watt lights, or 750 watts, are a more natural fit for my grow space. Basically, I've divided my area into four and positioned each light exactly in the center of each subsection. The Adjustawings double parabolic reflectors are incredibly good at creating uniform spreads of light, while their shape helps to mitigate heat buildup inside the reflector. As the name implies, you can also adjust the shape of the reflector on the fly so that it's tailor-made for your grow space. Nice! My 5x5 movable test grid has holes drilled every 112 millimeters. That's just under 4.5 inches. Each hole is just big enough for me to poke my Apogee MQ500 quantum sensor through. The rigid hole helps to ensure that the sensor is as close to 90 degrees as possible relative to the test grid. Apogee's quantum sensors are convex and stated to be cosine corrected in an effort to improve the accuracy when measuring scattered or angular light. It's worth noting that as the distance between my light sensor and the actual light source increases, the angle of the predominant light that strikes the sensor becomes more acute and the associated PPFD readings decrease surprisingly quickly. Further, if I tilt the sensor to face the direction of the arc tube, the PPFD readings often increase and quite considerably in some cases. However, the standard procedure is to keep the angle of the sensor at 90 degrees pointed straight up at the ceiling for all readings. This maintains consistency of experimental method, which is all well and good, but I'd argue that my current methodology favors the design of multi-point LED and T5 fixtures where the light source is invariably overhead. I'll discuss angular light and canopy penetration in more detail in an upcoming video. The reflectors have been set to their second widest setting and positioned 60 centimeters, that's just 2 feet, above the test panel, allowing for the extra 2 centimeters that the quantum meter probe pokes through. I measured the light intensity at 460 test points across the 69 square feet, and here are the results. Bam! Doesn't that look beautiful? I've got peaks of around 800 micromoles right underneath each lamp and lows of around 350 at the open side of my grow space. If you compare this to the opposite side, which benefits from the matte white wall's reflectivity, you can get an idea of how much light you lose to open spaces in your grow room. This is one main reason to fill the entire room with plants. The intensity overall, however, is incredible. Check out how the pattern is transformed when I add super spreaders beneath each lamp. Now, I'm going to talk about these ingenious devices in more detail in a follow-up video. video, but look how amazing they are at diffusing those hot spots and making the light even more homogeneous. Another small anomaly I'd like to point out is this little dim section right here, right by the alcove, which is acting as a trap for reflected light. No big deal, but interesting to see the physical quirks of my grow space manifesting directly in the PPFD data. And just in case you were wondering, this space is all being illuminated at just under 35 watts per square foot. 2400 watts divided by 69 square feet, the efficiencies come from the double-ended lamp, the reflector design, and the incredible super spreaders which permit a much closer hanging distance while protecting plants from the infrared overload. Obviously, the proof will be in the pudding, or maybe in the spotted dick, or a toad in the hole, but for now, I'll leave it there. If you're looking for intensity but don't have 15 high-foot ceilings to play with, I definitely recommend checking out the 450, 600, 750-watt double-ended systems before you default to 1,000 watts. I've included a link to a handy online lighting plan tool in the description below. If you want me to drill down into more examples, just let me know. There are so many variables that it's difficult to cover everything in one video. Thank you for watching. This is Everest, always intense yet evenly distributed, saying goodbye.